وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
What is more important for a woman, the right of her husband or the right of her parents? الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على عبد الله ورسوله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. So this is a question which is asked frequently. And here the first thing I want to establish is, I want to establish that birrul walidain is one of the biggest obligations that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed upon a Muslim male and female. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran, وَاعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Worship Allah, don't make any partner with Him, and have ihsan towards your parents. And the basic position is that this should continue in all of the situation of the life of a Muslim, male and female, married and unmarried, that they should continue to have this birr towards their parents. But the real question is here, when there is a clash between what the parents wish for, what the parents want, and what the husband asks, which one of them should be put ahead? Here, there is no doubt that the right of the husband takes priority for a married woman. And that's why Imam Ahmad was asked this question about a married woman who had a sick mother. And he said, طَاعَةُ زَوْجِهَا أَوْجَبُ عَلَيْهَا مِنْ أُمِّهَا إِلَّا أَنْ يَأْذَنَ لَهَا. He said that obedience to her husband is more obligatory for her than going to look after her mother unless he gives her permission. And this, unless he gives her permission, I think this is essential to understand, that the basic concept is she has to do birrul walidain. She has to look after her mother. However, the husband, ultimately, if there's a clash, that's when it takes priority. So what is the position of that husband in that situation? Of course, that husband wants to cooperate with his wife upon goodness. وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى وَلَا تَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. He wants to be able to help his wife in doing good and keeping away from sin. So if he sees there's an opportunity to support his wife to be good to her mother, then I think he should take that opportunity, if that opportunity is available to him. However, when there is a clash, that's when we ask the question, okay, which of them goes first? There's a clash. The mother says, you have to come, I need you here. The husband says, you have to be here, I need you here. Which of them now gets priority? If the wife isn't able to convince her husband or convince her mother, and it remains that there's a clash, there's a ta'arud. If that ta'arud, that clash is there, then the husband has to have priority. And that just shows you the right of the husband in Islam and how important it is. But having said that, that doesn't mean that right should be abused. And that doesn't mean that the husband should be sort of stopping his wife from a good deed that doesn't do any harm to him. You know, it doesn't do any harm to him. And it's sad that in this day, we have seen that from some husbands. We have seen that mentality that you have to cut off your wife from her family in order to, you know, sort of make her heart, you know, completely for you, or to make, you know, to give her 100% focus upon your rights. But ultimately, that's not going to bring her nearer to Allah or you nearer to Allah in reality. What is, though, is helping each other to do good. And the husband looks at the situation and he has the right. He has the right. If he sees that he requires or needs his wife at that time when her mother needs her or her father needs her, and he isn't able to find a way to reconcile between that, then his right comes first once the woman is married. There's no doubt about that. However, it doesn't mean that he should exercise that simply to show that he has that power. Rather, he should be wise and gentle and kind and look for opportunities for good deeds. SubhanAllah, Allah Azza wa Jalla described something wonderful about the companions. وَيُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصَةٌ. They give up their rights for other people even though they're in need of them. That's one of the things that made the companions, subhanAllah, it made them of the level that they had along with their companionship of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One of their characteristics that we're told about them is that they gave up their rights for other people even though they were in need of them. So that kind of idea, that kind of concept of ithar, of giving up your rights sometimes. You know, you see, for example, that her mother is unwell and her mother needs her daughter to be with her. And you see that, to be honest, the husband is able to give up that and to expect the reward from Allah. Then there's no doubt that is more befitting than for him to simply exercise his right without thinking about how that would impact upon other people. So yes, the husband, when a woman is married, the husband's right takes priority over the parent's right. But that doesn't mean that she is excluded from the obligation of birr al-walidain, and it doesn't mean that her husband has to exercise that right at every moment in time. And Allah Azza wa Jalla knows best.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.